all the prime rib is a horseradish carrying vehicle.
Oh.
Is that atomic horseradish or what?
As a chef and restaurant owner, Las Vegas has always enticed me. It is truly the heart of the hospitality world, a land of extremes, excess, and indulgence. Somehow, I've never made my way out to the desert, up until now. So join me on my odyssey through the city of sin, on the strip, off the strip, and taking in the uniqueness of Vegas any way I can. This is the Munchies Guide to Vegas, Classics. There's no better place to kick off my time in Vegas than the iconic Peppermill Restaurant. Unchanged for the last 50 years, the interior harkens back to an old Vegas that is becoming harder and harder to find. I met Faraday under the mirror ball ceiling for an over-the-top breakfast you can only find here.
Ah, Faraday!
Steve!
Hey, Dylan.
So nice to see you here in Vegas. Is this your first time in Vegas?
First time.
Are you excited?
I have no expectations. I've only seen Vegas in the movies, like The Hangover.
That's your jumping off point, is The Hangover.
Yeah.
Oh, we've got a lot to do. I'm no expert on Vegas. I've been here a few times. The thing about Vegas that I love is that the last like 20 years, it's like really like kind of changed into like a big, more resort stuff. But like the old school, like the classic side of Vegas is something that like really intrigues me. And the Peppermill is the spot. You walk through the doors here and you're like walking back through time, you know?
We opened December 26, 1972. I think it was iconic when it started. Now we've been here this December 50 years. It's very eclectic, it's old Vegas. Some people ask if we were a strip club or does it turn into a strip club at night. It's pretty much stayed. You know, people love it. And if we change it, they lose their mind.
Should we order?
Yeah, let's do it. So hungry.
I'm starving. And the menu is ridiculous. I mean, there's like pages and pages of food here. I mean, it's morning. We'll get a waiter over here and we're gonna do like a scorpion bowl. We're gonna get some French toast. I heard that the French toast ambrosia, it's like thick French toast, a bunch of fruit, all the toppings, whipped cream. We need to get this. They also have a Maserati omelet, which sounds crazy. We're gonna do some other like classic things. The Munchies breakfast.
The Munchies breakfast, done.
What?
French toast.
Holy.
This is phenomenal. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hey man, this is Sin City. Cheers.
In 90s fashion.
This is like making me feel like a kid again, that one.
So the Maserati omelet.
So it has like sausage in it, there's cheese, there's like a meat sauce on top of it. It literally sounds and looks like pizza. That's delicious. It really does taste like pizza. Help me.
Keeps on going. So glorious. I love Vegas.
This is the Munchies one, right?
Mm-hmm. That sausage is great.
This is good. This is like your little hodgepodge of everything you want for breakfast. Can't wrap my head around this. It's so good. Everything, like the atmosphere, the vibe, the food. This is the epitome of Sin City like breakfast, I feel like.
If this is what like classic diner food is like in Vegas, I can't wait to see what everything else is.
Well, I hope you enjoy the rest of your time. I think this is gonna be awesome. I'm so excited to see where else you go. Nothing's gonna beat this, in my opinion.
The image of the white rhinestone jumpsuit is synonymous with the glitz of Vegas. Countless Elvis Presley impersonators are an ever-present facet of the strip, and for good reason. After a rough patch in his career, Elvis came to Vegas to resurrect his image while at the same time reinventing the Vegas stage show. Curious about this Vegas-specific profession, I sought out to see what a day in the life of an Elvis impersonator is really like.
Do I call you Mr. Presley?
Oh, Chris is my name, man, but Counterfeit Elvis is my stage name.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Same here. People been calling me Elvis since for nearly 30 years. I started learning to sing, getting backing tracks, and going to places with karaoke and singing. I got better and better at it.
What's your favorite like Elvis dance move?
And then I do, I'm pretty good at the martial arts, so I do a lot of that.
It would be an honor to be the apprentice to one of the last remaining Elvis personators.
There's still plenty of us left, but like I said, there ain't too many on the strip.
But you're the best.
I ain't the worst, but I probably ain't the best either.
All right, I'm gonna change.
Hey, Steve, you look good, man.
Thank you.
Thanks, man. Just try to fix your collar so I get that to stay up like that, you know. After you, man.
After you.
I wish I had some chest hair to complete the outfit. Hey!
Thank you.
Hey, what are your sidekick doing? I'm the Elvis guy, man. I didn't do it, the blue blaze suit.
Also, got just, you know, something like that. And then I do, you know, do punch, block punch, kick.
Kick.
Hey, babe.
I know my friend.
Claudia, let's go.
Give your room number, baby, and I'll be there.
I don't know my room number. I need your way, babe. Have fun.
I love the positivity.
Yeah.
I'm just a honk, Bernie.
What's up, Elvis? How you doing, brother?
Thanks, man.
After spending a day doing this on the strip, these guys work super hard, and it's definitely not for me. The Steakhouse is the most quintessential restaurant experience in Las Vegas. And in a city where there seems to be a high-end steakhouse on every corner, the Golden Steer remains in a class above the rest. And who better to join me for dinner at the Steer than John Curtis, Vegas's most revered food writer and historian.
Good to see you, man.
It's great. This is great.
This is so cool.
You've never been here before, have you?
I've never been to Vegas.
Oh, what?
After you, here. Las Vegas history is at your feet, right here. You got Sammy Davis's booth, Dean Martin's booth, Frank Sinatra's booth right there. Just a little bit of history.
We're sitting at the Golden Steer with the legendary John Curtis.
At the legendary Golden Steer.
I understand that steakhouses are super important to Las Vegas lore and its culture.
I like to say, Steve, that every restaurant in Las Vegas would be a steakhouse if it could be. They are the most profitable restaurants. They're some of our best restaurants. And I'll put our steakhouses up against any cities in America.
Hendricks, Gibson, Vermouth, Ezra
Wilson. Now they're better than gin before a steak, too. Because steak means Vegas.
The Golden Steer also means Vegas, like it's a quintessential restaurant.
There was a secret door right across from you here where the mob guys, they used this place like a country club. And that's what kept this place going back in the 1970s. Well, it had that cachet, the Rat Pack showed up here. So they have the booze throughout the Golden Steer where Dean Martin sat, Sammy Davis, Sinatra. I mean, the Golden Steer is really our most historical and the most fun steakhouse to go to.
I'm gonna prepare the Caesar salad here for you gentlemen.
This has gotten to be a lost art, the fact that they make it tableside and have always made it tableside. I think going back to 1958 when this place started.
What was dining scene like when you got to Vegas?
When I came to Vegas in 1990, there was probably a dozen good restaurants in town, but then it just blew up.
Vegas just kind of looks like capitalism on steroids.
Yeah, the land of excess, and nothing says excess like steaks.
I'll set that right here for you, sir.
Oh, okay, that's all I want. Thank you very much.
Steak for a king. So that's the brandy cream sauce. That's Bernays there. Bernays goes well with the filet mignon. I like the brandy cream with the ribeye. That is the peppercorn sauce. Brandy that's cream. Like sweet and spicy. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Oh my goodness.
Oh! Is that atomic horseradish or what? Yes! This, to me, is better than sex right here, okay? Béarnaise on a filet mignon. I don't know if it gets any better than that. I think the filet here is really, really delicious and one of the reasons to come here.
My mouth was having sex with itself.
Mouth was having sex with itself. It's celebratory food. It's big food. It's American food. It's everything I love about good restaurants in Las Vegas. You want to get the flavor of Vegas, you come to these old places. The Golden Steer is one of those places where you cannot replicate this because people are hungry for tradition and they're hungry for the great flavors of the past. And this is why we come to places like the Golden Steer.
Experiencing the classics doesn't have to mean spending all of your money. It's about authenticity over price.
We're outside of Hunter's Tavern. It's been around since the 1960s. It's a local institution. The drinks are cheap. All the locals come here. I can't wait to head inside and grab a Long Island. It's been a wild trip thus far. So we're here with Buck, the general manager of Hunter's Tavern. What makes this place so special?
I think just the realness of it. You know, it's an anybody bar. It's 24 hours. It's basically the original neighborhood bar. We have packaged liquor here, which means you can, you know, buy a six pack or a bottle to go. And that dates all the way back to the early 60s when this was also the liquor store.
Who comes in here?
Doctors, lawyers, cooks, chefs like yourself, a lot of service industry people. There's no real theme. You know, we do updates when necessary. You know, we're not trying to make it a fancy place. It's, you know, it's no bullshit. You don't really get very many old, untouched dive bars in Las Vegas.
Just that.
Cheers.
Actually, can we do the,
do you want fire shots?
The hangover?
Do you want to join in? What's your name?
Carlos.
I'm Steve. I would shake your hand, but I'm holding a shot.
Yeah.
And then we got one more shot. Would you like this?
Cheers to the 100.
Cheers to the 100.
Salud.
Real simple. The more you suck, the less you suck. We're gonna like clank your glasses, hit the table, and drink the straw. Last one to finish has to drink that one. That's it. So bring the glasses in. Bring it in.
Are we good? All right. Cheers.
Still got some.
Good sports, guys. Good sports. Good sports. Good sports. Hell yeah. Thanks for playing, guys.
Welcome to Vegas.
Thanks for watching. Click above to see more of our Vegas coverage.